Does atypical lobular hyperplasia increase the risk of a future breast cancer? Let me share with you some important information on this subject. Atypical hyperplasia. What is that? Well, the cells that line the inside of the ducts of the breast and also the cells that line the inside of the lobules of the breast can begin to change. And those changes are often called atypical, meaning they don't look like the normal cells. Now, there are around 1 million breast biopsies performed in the United States each year, and around 10% of the time, a diagnosis of atypical lobular hyperplasia or atypical ductal hyperplasia is made. Usually, this is from a needle core biopsy, and also usually a recommendation is made for an excisional biopsy to make sure that we're not missing an underlying cancer. The incidence of the occult or underlying cancer is usually quite low. Now, in the early January issue from the New England Journal of Medicine was a very special article published in 2015 on this very subject of atypical hyperplasia. It comes from Dr. Lynn Hartman and colleagues at the Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota. This is really an important overview article that gets into the subject of atypical hyperplasia of the breast in greater depth than I've seen in a long time. The bottom line of the paper is that indeed there is an increased risk of a future breast cancer with either atypical ductal hyperplasia or atypical lobular hyperplasia. That increased risk is around 30% at 25 years. Now, what should we do about that? Well, if you have that diagnosis, and particularly if you have that diagnosis associated with a positive family history for breast cancer, then there's no doubt in my mind that you need to be seen and evaluated at a multidisciplinary center, and likely your annual screening should include breast MRI. The national standards for using breast MRI now are a lifetime risk of 20% to 25% or greater. And clearly that's the case with a typical ductal or a typical lobular hyperplasia of the breast. Now, if you had an extremely strong family history but yet are gene negative, then perhaps even a recommendation for preventative mastectomies might be made. Now, there have been prevention trials around for several years conducted both here in the United States and in Europe that have looked at the effectiveness of using drugs like tamoxifen, raloxifene, exemestane as a way of lowering the subsequent risk of future breast cancer if, in fact, you have atypical changes. That lowering of the risk is probably around 33%, plus or minus a little bit. The difficulty with these regimens is that the side effects of the tamoxifen or raloxifene or the exemestane may turn women off from wanting to be on the preventative programs. But clearly the preventative programs work. So the bottom line is if you have a diagnosis of either atypical ductal hyperplasia or atypical lobular hyperplasia, please be seen and evaluated by a multidisciplinary breast center. Also consider adding or having them consider adding breast MRI to your routine screening. Also potentially consider being on a preventative medication to do what's called chemo prevention. The bottom line is, indeed, your risk of a future breast cancer is increased. Be proactive and take the appropriate steps to deal with that issue.
Did you know that not every breast cancer patient needs chemotherapy? In fact, today, there's a way to identify whether or not you'd benefit from that chemotherapy based on the biology of your tumor. To learn more about the Oncotype DX assay and how to discuss the results with your physician, just press this button.